Episode 2688, Rules Are For Who?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. It's Friday. Yes, it is. I'm so excited. I hope you're excited because guess what? The weekend is around the corner, and more importantly, my grandson is here. Oh, yes, I am celebrating. It is so awesome to have a baby around. I know he's getting into everything, but let me tell you, rules are for who? Oh, let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, as a parent and a grandparent, you are positioned to raise your children to write their own stories. But at times, you might be stealing the pen. Rules are for who? If only there were more ways to learn how to parent, maybe this world would be in a better place. Or would it? The school year has come to a close for our youngest son with his exemption from finals. Yes, now the end of school technically is next week, but he is done. However, he does have many friends that are required to take exams. Lucky for him, though, his hard work throughout the school year paid off. So why can't we have our parenting years end early with no final exams? Seriously, I really think that would be a miracle. But what I have found is that most of us parent to what the child is going through, not where the child is headed or directed. So to a degree, we as parents are two steps behind our children because we are always looking back to fix what happened. What if? And you know me and my what ifs. What if parents could work a step or two ahead of where the child is going? Do you think life would be different for the better? Most definitely. If you are always a jumping bean, have you ever seen those jumping beans? I don't know why I had this in my head, but I just see these jumping beans. And I remember I was in, I think, a Spanish class. Honestly, I know it sounds kind of weird. And our teacher brought in jumping beans. And you know what? They really do jump. It's kind of freaky and cool all at the same time. But a jumping bean reacts, right? It doesn't just all of a sudden start jumping. It jumps because of a reaction to its stimulus. So we are doing the same thing as parents, right? We're like a jumping bean, always reacting to what's around us. And there's no room to get ahead when that happens. You want to be able to respond in a way that opens up a dialogue while increasing and enhancing what the child needs within his or her stage of life. Now, I know that's a mouthful, but why not study early and get a free pass out of class? You've got to respond, not react. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Respond, not react. And this is so hard. Let me just tell you, it is so hard. I try to be that good mama. I try to be that good grandmama too. And sometimes I just get it flat out wrong. But I must tell you, there are times, give me the crown. I am awesome. And it's good that we recognize that about ourselves. That doesn't mean I do everything right by any means because I fail more than I succeed. But you see, I have learned. And this is one thing I have learned. So I'm telling you a hidden secret if you don't already know it. You got to respond, not react. Don't let your head hit the pillow if you're too many steps behind your children. You can't let them get ahead. I'm serious. Do you wonder if children manipulate? 120,000%. They do. Why? Because they're ahead of you. They've learned. They follow your patterns. They're paying attention because they're going after something. Children are the best salespeople ever. Seriously, think about it. They sell you every single day. Think about it. The next conversation, you're going to have me in the back of your mind. Oh, Christiane said they're the best saleswoman ever, the best salesman ever. Oh, yeah, they are. You just listen the next time they say, hey, mom, can I go do this? Yeah. Well, understand. They may want to manipulate. They may want to get their own way, but you can still be ahead of the game. Children do need to grow, right, within their own abilities and talents and gifts and all. However, when you are the sole provider for right versus wrong, notice how I said that. When you're the sole provider for right versus wrong, you better be two steps ahead, or you'll be backtracking for years to come. You really will. And you don't want to get caught up in that. And on top of it, you don't want someone else sneaking in and being the influencer in your child's life. Now, yes, they're going to have teachers and mentors and people from the community and from the church, and even a stranger can be a mentor, believe it or not. You can have now with the internet, oh my goodness, watch out. You may have mentors in your children's lives that you had no idea. So it's important that we're involved in our children's lives, but we have to come at it from the aspect of responding, not reacting. So what does that look like in real life? Number one, set your sights on the hills, not the valleys. This is knowing where you are leading your child. And yes, it's your job to lead them. Eventually, your child will take over the reins, but not until they've earned your trust and have reached an age that is agreeable for them to pursue without full consultation with you. So what that really means here is, okay, your child is going to fall flat a lot, and they're going to need to be picked back up. But you see, you don't focus on where they've fallen all the time. You, as the parent, have your sights set on the hills. You're always what? Raising them up. Raising them up into their greatness. They don't know they're great because they keep falling down. But they do have persistence, and they're willing to be consistent if they have the right coach, if they have the right, yes, you parent. So set your sights on the hills, not the valleys. Number two, see your child for what they don't see. You have got to be the eyes and ears for your children. And that means more work. Yeah, it does. It's more than a full-time job. Welcome to parenthood. I know if everybody knew what parenting was all about, they probably wouldn't have, number one, as many children, and some wouldn't have children at all. And they might actually make better decisions in not becoming a parent or being more responsible and ready before they became a parent, right? But all of that is for another episode. What I want you to see here is that, yes, it means more work, but it's really so rewarding. You have to do what a parent is supposed to do. Don't be a friend, be a compassionate leader. And I love that, because that means you're saying, look, I love you, I care for you. But that doesn't mean you get to walk all over me. That doesn't mean you get your way all the time. I'm here to guide you, to protect you, to raise you up, not to allow you to sink down here because you think that's where you should be, because oh, the friends you hang out with are all sinking right here too. No, it's time for you to rise up. You've got to carry the belief torch for your child until your child is ready to carry all the belief torches they're going to need to carry in order to get them into adulthood. Seriously. And that means, yeah, you got a lot of weight to carry. I'm just saying. So set your sights on the hills, not the valleys. See your child for what they don't see. And finally, number three, I love this one. Start with the art. Help your child paint their life picture every day. Make time to chat or grab a snack. Be present both physically and emotionally. And I know that's hard. Put your daggum phone down. Emotionally, listen, lean in, hear what they're not saying. Watch their body language. What happens to their eyes? Does one get a little bit droopy? Does their head kind of go cocky to the side? Do their shoulders slump? Yeah, all of that. I know it's an art. It truly is. But you have to be present both physically and emotionally for your child. And as your child goes from infancy to teenager, grow with them, not against them. Don't sit there and say, oh my gosh, your child's in the terrible twos and they're only 16 months old. Yeah, no. I have a grandson. He's right there. He's not even two yet. We've already reached it. But guess what? That doesn't mean I run around crazy, yelling and screaming just because he's doing it too. No, this is a stage of life in which I get to help him, guess what? Discover his inside voice. Ha! Huh? Amazing, right? But we all have to discover our inside voices. It's a stepping stone to the rest of his life. But I also have to be there when he falls down and gets a boo-boo and he needs his grandmama to kiss his knee, right? So infancy through teenager, you've got to grow with them, not against them. They're going to fail. And you're going to feel like you failed because they failed. This is not a reflection on you. You're doing the best that you can, but you have to build your consistency. And the more persistent that you're consistent, the more opportunity you bring your child, which honestly is a beautiful thing. So it's time to invest in your child. So you know those rules? They're more for you than for your child. Seriously, set your own boundaries and then sculpt your child's every day. This is a beautiful moment to be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.